I just watched the Monique video. She wants us to boycott Netflix because they only offer her $500,000. Monique, $500,000 might not be shit to you or me or Chris Rock, Dave Chappelle, or the white woman that got 11 million. But it means a lot to these broke niggas that are following us. It could be their 10-year income, so you're not going to get much support there. Plus, cable costs $200. DirecTV costs $150. Netflix costs $9.99, and niggas love discounts. Plus, I'm waiting on my next flick deal, so I can't really fuck with it right now. Now, if they offer me some bullshit like 40 cents a day, then I'll tell niggas to kiss my ass. But as for right now, Stranger Things are about to come on, so I have to go. Good luck, Monique.
The real is back. I'm back. Yeah.
It's been a long time. I shouldn't have left you. Without that gangster music, you can rap to me. A long time. I shouldn't have left you without that gangster music. You can rap to.
Yo, what a time, my Damons. It's your boy Montoya and The Reese, and this is the Shoot from the Hip Show. Y'all can call and get it off the chest at 559-825-SHOT. You can reach us at shootfromthehip1@gmail.com, and you can follow us at @from_the_hip on Twitter, man. And we just listened to Michael Blackson, dog. Tell us about that, Del Reese.
Well, first of all, Michael Blackson, a comedian we all know. He running around here with his Nigerian or African thing going on.
Yeah, he's a,
so that's funny.
He's a popular motorcycle.
Yeah. So anyway, y'all heard Monique been going in on Netflix and all of that stuff. So he had his own little funny little spiel. I want to say go more in depth later in the show.
Yeah. Why we gotta wait?
Well, because it just we'll save it to after the break.
Sound good.
Yeah.
All right.
So anyway, like you said, we back. No voicemails, no breath, right?
No breath this week, man.
Hey, shame on y'all.
Yeah.
I know y'all got something on y'all mind.
Yeah, man. Tell Reese how he was wrong about something else, man.
Like,
we done got used to that.
Like black quarterbacks or black coaches.
We ain't heard much about that out of you, man.
Well, I mean, you know, I don't want to beat a dead drum, but.
You don't.
I mean, ain't one playing. Is it a black? I'm just saying, is there a better black quarterback than Nick Foles out there?
That was ugly, man.
Is it a who?
Russell Wilson.
He ain't in the Super Bowl.
I don't mean
that. Well, he's won some, but he ain't in
the
Super Bowl.
Yeah, I'm finna say, man, the best ones ain't always in the final game, man.
Really? The best quarterback is Tom Brady. He always there.
He ain't always
there. When you a good quarterback, you can will your team. You can hide a lot of deficiencies.
You can will your referees to throw you flags.
Yeah, not necessarily.
I watched it, dog. I'm sorry. I'm not necessarily a Pats hater like that. I mean, yeah, I'd rather see some other teams go, but I don't hate them like that.
Yeah.
And so I objectively watched that game.
I mean, I'm not surprised.
And I said, oh, whoa.
Well, I told.
Look at that flag.
I told it to somebody. I said, well, I tell you what. If Danny Amendola wouldn't have caught that pass in the back of the end zone.
Yeah.
It'd have been some type of flag or some type of shit would have came.
Yeah. So, it would have been.
I mean, does that take away from Tom Brady's greatness?
I was going to add to that. That you know, you got to give him his props.
Yeah,
you understand?
But yeah.
Don't act like it wasn't no help on the back end.
Okay, so again, there's no black quarterback. Did he even make it to the Final Four?
I don't know.
Is there a better black quarterback than Case Keenum?
We missed our picks.
I remember that.
Our picks.
You gonna get into it today?
Yeah, after the break, we gonna do that.
Okay, how about this? Before we even get there, I don't even know who won. Well, I can't remember. Can the Super Bowl pick be worth 3 points?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. You think so? No. Just one.
Well, shit, man. I'm going to have to brainstorm on that, dog.
Well, I'm just saying. If we tally up the points and the Super Bowl pick should be 3. Now, if we go against each other, then it matters. But if we pick the same, it don't matter.
What we ought to do is throw in a tiebreaker. Like, we pick the over and under as far as scores. Just in case we end up, you know.
We could do that.
So let's do that instead of add points to the Super Bowl.
Okay. All
right. You know, because I don't want that to be the thing. something about that didn't hit me right.
I'm just saying. I might lose.
I just rather have a tiebreaker, man, just in case.
Just in case?
Yeah.
Or you can, like if it sounds fishy, you can scramble. evade traffic.
Yeah, get out the pocket.
Yeah.
Yeah, like a beautiful black quarterback. Mm-hmm. Anyway, man, I got this joke, dog.
Let's go.
All right. How do you kill a circus clown?
Schumann knows.
Go for the jugular. Badoon team.
Badoon team.
Little trip to Cornyville right there.
Man, do you know how to juggle?
Nah.
No?
No.
I always wanted to juggle.
Yeah.
Well, not like that, but I always tried to figure it out.
I've done two. I can't add the third one in there.
I can't do it. So.
Yeah, I did when I was a youngster, man, but.
Yeah.
Nah, I don't think I got the dexterity. I like that word. I don't have that for it.
All right. So the Montoyas has moved, if y'all haven't heard.
Yeah, man.
How's that transition been?
Man, it's going, man. I think I told y'all about me, my dogs breaking the fence last week.
Yeah.
And I met the neighbors on the other side.
Oh shit.
It wasn't that bad, but it was kind of funny.
Because of the dogs?
No.
Okay.
No. I was moving some shit from my truck to the house, and they were outside loading up the minivan.
They white?
Yeah.
They want to know what kind of work you did, right?
Well, no, it didn't come to that. Okay. I think they saw me.
Man, you tell them you're a motivational speaker slash
they
pastor.
Saw me taking my equipment in the house. They know what I do.
Okay.
But they was like, hey, welcome to the neighborhood. I said, hey, what's going on, y'all? I'll come properly introduce myself in a second. I was moving stuff. So I'll go over there. And so I'm talking to the dude. He got his Astro shirt on, so he's a hometown cat.
Yeah.
You know, I'm digging that. Then his wife came out and passed me what they called their contact card. It had all the family members' names on it.
You kidding
and their
me?
Phone number.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Menage a trois time.
I don't know about that, but I've never been in that kind of situation before.
Really?
And then, while I was out there,
you should have gave him yours.
I don't have one.
Your daddy?
I know her.
Ill Ran.
Yeah, no. I wasn't doing that. That'd be funny.
Yeah.
Yeah. Ran Senior.
Yeah.
Ill Ran.
Yeah.
You know. But yeah, man, a whole contact card with the address, the parents, the two adults, and the kids' names.
Really?
All that on there.
No shit.
Contact card.
Yeah, did they give you the,
I mean, it's cool.
Give you the Netflix password?
I know. No, they did. It seemed like it, right?
They going to let you splice into that cable? They know yeah. You don't fuck with cable?
Yeah, I know, huh? So I took the little dog out to use the restroom.
In the front or back?
In the front.
Okay.
And right as I did that, here come a lady walking two little dogs. It looked just like him down the street.
Mm-hmm.
So she stopped across the street and waved at me. Hey, welcome to the neighborhood. So I picked a little dog. I go over there, introduce myself and whatnot.
Mm.
I say, man, this look all kind of bad. It's got the makings of some fuck shit. Extra friendly ass day was waving.
Yeah.
And I don't know what the lady's, she kind of intimated that she lives by herself and pointed at the house.
I see a little get out going on.
Hey. That's exactly what I thought. Now I'm fighting a sunken place in this.
Yeah.
Game. Oh man. But you know, everything's still kind of jumbled up.
Yeah. Now that is us being ignorant, because there could be no fuck shit involved.
Yeah, they just nice, man. Yeah. I hope.
Yeah.
You know, wait, man. That did cross my mind to get out though. But yeah.
Okay. So everything cool. Met all the neighbors.
Well, met a
one
few.
Contact card.
One contact card.
How your utilities coming along? Everything hooked up?
Yeah, I switched that over before we got in there.
So you good?
Yeah.
All right, that internet purring like a champ?
Like a champ.
Okay. All right.
I wanted to get the Google Wi-Fi, you know, like a mesh thing.
I'm thinking about so
Eero does it too.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, we'll get to that. We'll say that too. I always say we're going to say some shit, then we don't get to it.
Then we don't get to it. That's why we got to just
remind
do it.
Me.
All right.
Because I don't like to get off track. Anyway, my wife celebrated her birthday.
How did that go, man? I saw pictures.
It went off like a, it went good.
I heard tell that you got a little toasted.
I did.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, you got to.
You supposed to do that.
Supposed to do that.
That's right.
Yeah. I was waiting on you to show up. Didn't happen.
I couldn't do it, man. We
man,
still,
you could have.
We were moving shit around there, man. Then she started cooking. And I thought to myself, my old lady can't drink right now. And the last thing she needs is to be over here around y'all drinking.
She drink like that?
No, she don't.
Not like that, but she like to indulge socially, though.
Yeah.
Okay.
And that would be like torture, man. You don't
that's,
see
the, that's the price you pay. Fuck that.
I hear you.
I ain't
I hear you.
That's part of being a man and part of being a woman.
Uh-oh.
It is.
Yeah, okay.
So I'm just saying, shit. Right. Hey. Fuck that.
All right, sir.
Okay. But anyway, so we did have a good time. I smoked some ribs and some sausage. That was pretty good.
Okay.
Yeah, that crowd pleaser.
Yeah,
I did three racks, not one.
I was just going to ask you how many racks you did.
I did three.
Jabbing at me, man? I did two that one time, and we had like five people come by. That was enough, man.
Okay, yeah. So I was going to do four, but four with the size of my pit, which is not a small pit.
Yeah.
It just take a little bit more work. That's a lot of more.
It'll fill up the space.
It'll fill up, and I gotta just be there to make sure, you know, one, because what I do every hour, I put a mop on my ribs.
You mop it,
yeah, and then I rotate them to bring the one. You know, I bring the one that's close to the heat. I move that to the back.
Yeah,
that's just something that I do,
like a little conveyor belt type.
Yeah, exactly. Every hour, you know, while I got them smoking. So
All right.
That shit just would have just took more time.
And you just gonna get that big one, man.
That sounds like something I might ask for my 40th birthday.
Yeah, you might as well just go on out.
Where am I
gonna
put it though?
In the same spot.
Nah, I mean, see what it's doing to my bathroom outside.
Yeah.
See, that ain't gonna work.
Well, you can work around that.
I don't know. We'll talk about
that.
But anyway, so the party was cool, man. Everybody not everybody, but a lot of people showed up.
Yeah.
Had a lot of good, you know, a lot of good fun. We drank, had shots.
There you go.
We gambled a little bit.
Y'all
with that
real
left, right,
take shots around this bitch.
Ooh, that's gonna happen, baby.
Left, right, center. What's that?
Yeah, you can get, man, my laptop doing it. So, this bitch out, nigga.
Okay.
So anyway,
oh yeah.
Okay, so we played the game left, right, center. Three dice, and you play it with $3.
CeeLo,
is that what it's called?
No, I just have them New Yorkers call it.
Okay, so probably that's what we did. We did that, and that's a crowd pleaser.
Huh?
We was drinking, talking Soon shit. Die. Then we played
like some
Taboo
shut
with some new cards. They wasn't ready for them new cards.
Oh yeah, Taboo with some different words.
Yeah, most different women questions. Know them old cards.
Yeah.
So yeah, I brought a new game of Taboo out. They ain't like that.
There you go.
Yeah.
So, must have been old Nasty.
Nah. No, what you mean? Because of me?
Yeah.
Nah. we had some Christians in here.
I know you.
We had Christians in here.
Well, they know what they're doing. They come over here. Did they drink?
Yeah.
All right, then. Bet on. Game. Speaking of bet, man.
So, hold on.
Okay.
And we played a game called Black Card Revoked. You ever played that?
No.
It's pretty fun.
Black Card
Revoked.
Revoked.
That's a lot of... questions that are relative to Black culture.
Okay.
You know,
All right.
See what you say.
So it was like a history lesson.
Yeah.
Okay.
And one of them was your favorite sitcom. It was Good Times, Martin, right. Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, and like...
Now that's Cosby a show. What was yours?
I went... But see, the thing is, not how you feel, it's what's going to win the game.
Okay. Well, what won the game?
Martin.
Martin.
Yeah.
Okay, I can see that.
So, and then
how did Cosby fare?
It didn't rank them. Just go with, you could, if you would have saw the visual of what the card that people was holding up.
I guess I got to see the game.
Then you got to see the game. So yeah. It's a pretty cool game. You might want to invest
Black
in it.
Card Revoked.
Black Card Revoked.
All right.
So yeah. But anyway, that's what we
revoked
did.
Revoked with R-E-V-O-K-E-D.
Yeah. What you thought of me?
A revoke like.
No. Black Card Revoked.
Okay. The Black Card. I get you now. I don't know what the hell I was thinking.
Yeah, so
I ain't even drinking. Cool. That's what the problem
is. I'm sure some people who listen to the show have played it before.
Yeah, so. That sounds dope.
Yep. So you got anything else going on?
Oh no, man, that move took up all my time.
Took up all your time, huh?
Yeah, man. Well, I did lose money on that game, the Jacksonville New England game. I called Bob up. I slapped 50 on it.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
So how did you give him money? You PayPal him?
Well, no, we just. You know, he come to town, I knock stuff off. I go over there, he knocks stuff off. So we
okay.
This is how we do things.
Okay,
and man, it felt good most of that game, dog. Except that fourth quarter.
I didn't see none of
it. That fourth quarter was like, here it go.
Yep, I knew it. I wasn't surprised.
Here it go.
I was surprised that it was as close as it was.
I should have bet the money line. The points. I should have took the points, man. I bet flat out that Jacksonville was gonna win.
Yeah.
And I could have had TV money.
Really?
Yeah.
With $50?
Well, it put me a lot closer than, not a lot closer.
Well, I mean, it'll help.
It showed, damn sure would have helped, man. Because, nigga, I'm telling you right now, I go get the bitch.
Yeah.
I'm just trying to keep the peace in the house.
All right. Well, plus, I mean, when you move, man, it's one thing after another. And it don't stop.
Matter of fact, this is what I'm going through right now. Went to Conn's to get the appliances.
Okay.
All right. Now, the freeze hit, so they can't deliver.
I'm familiar.
They couldn't deliver. They finally delivered the fridge and the dryer.
Yeah.
And no washer. Like, what the hell happened with the washer?
Yeah.
Come to find out, they sold a washer to somebody else after we paid for it.
So how did they fix that?
They haven't yet.
But they supposed to fix it.
Today is going to be D-Day for that.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Man, how you fucked that up?
Yeah.
And you told me you didn't get a screen in the dryer. Did you fix that?
Oh, screen?
You said you didn't get the screen in a dryer. You told me that like a few days ago.
I'm not even sure what you're talking about there.
The screen you pull out catches the linen?
Oh, shit. I don't know.
Did you fix that?
I didn't know. Oh, shit, I didn't even look.
Oh, so is that? Man, I thought you told me.
I didn't tell you that, man.
Somebody told
Your
me
that. Your ass.
That,
you was on that Behringer wine. That set a home. And,
hey, man. Hey.
Screen. Yeah, anyway. So, we waiting on Khan.
Oh, my bad.
No, it was cool.
All right, let's talk to the news. 559-825, self-force is a 559-825-SHOT. Larry Nassar, whatever, he just been sentenced. We watching as we prepping for this
Ooh,
show.
They drug him through
they
that
drug
one,
him
bro.
Through the mud. It's about a good... How long you been here? It's about 30 minutes? So
yeah.
45 minutes?
Yeah.
And they been tanning into him for 45 minutes. Up, instead man. Of just putting that man in his box.
I'm like, damn, man, can't you just swing the gavel and ship his ass off?
TV's
no.
in there.
No. They... beat him down word for word.
Word for word.
And he just said the same thing 15 different ways.
What'd she
then,
say?
she broke out a cheat sheet.
Yeah.
And started dropping numbers on it.
Mm, facts.
Yeah. And what'd she say?
She said, I just signed your death warrant.
I just signed your death warrant.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. It is my pleasure to give you 40 years.
Yeah. And I don't know if that's professional.
It wasn't. It was
she supposed to keep her mind.
It was petty, dog. Yeah, that whole thing was very petty.
That's that Me Too movement.
Yeah. Yeah, there you go, boy. Me Too, boy.
Shit, Too Short got hit with that Me Too.
Did he?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Bitch!
Yeah, exactly. I bet that was his reply to that, too.
Yeah, I listened to Breakfast Club interviews, and he has text messages that will show that they're trying to extort him.
Yeah, man. Yeah, y'all ain't getting short, dog.
Nigga, too short, baby.
His whole life.
Rap.
God damn it.
He been talking
Motherfuck
about
you, damn shithead bitch.
So anyway, if you have a daughter or a child, period, being teached or coached by other adults, just pay attention.
Yeah.
I just don't know how he was able to get away with.
Yeah, I don't know that.
One girl. Then 5 girls. He been sexually assaulting many little girls.
For a while.
And to what degree, I don't know.
Yeah.
I think one of them was going at him hard, very vividly about the details of what he did.
Okay, so how long had this been going on?
Man, a long time. For years, apparently.
So. Well, I tell you what, they sure got him up and in court pretty damn quick about it.
They did, man. They did.
Versus all the other ones.
Well, that's that Me Too right now going on.
Well, I tell you what, if you get jokers like that, you catch them, if it's 5 years ago, I don't care, whatever it is, but if you can get it and you can prove it, do just like that. Bring his ass to court and ship his ass off, man.
Yeah.
I'm all for that.
Yeah.
But don't be wait 30 years until, you know, ship the ship and sail to be come back like, well, this happened to me. Yeah, and I want something for
he
it.
He should have got R. Kelly lawyer.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't know. See, what the fuck going on with R. Kelly, man? I don't get
He's
it.
He's still pissing on girls.
He got video of it, nigga.
Yeah.
How do you get off?
Hey, man.
Oh, man.
It wasn't him.
Yeah, well, when you make I Believe I Can Fly, man, you get away with anything.
All right.
Yeah.
All right, so Stormy Daniels, you familiar? I don't know. We didn't talk about this last time.
No.
She's the porn star that got she was giving some hush money before the election.
For Trump?
Yeah.
Okay.
So yeah. She's been doing her rounds, and then her buddy, Alana Evans, been doing her rounds, talking about the tryst that happened at one of
his. The tryst?
Well, you know.
Go ahead. Boy, I see you. That's, well, that nigga, that's like eighth grade right there.
I know, huh? So anyway, her friend Alana Evans, went on Megyn Kelly's Women's Rights show.
Uh-oh.
And she spilled the beans on what happened.
Yeah.
So anyway, they were at some type of golf tournament. And she met him. He invited her over. She also
Trump. We're talking about Trump.
And this all is right. Why he's married to Melania. And also, she's also saying that they called her, wanted her to, and, you know, get in the fun. Her response was, he ain't Brad Pitt.
Get in the fun.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So anyway, that's out there. So you.
He's the Teflon Don, dog. You can say what you want about him.
Yeah.
Ain't nothing going to stick.
It's coming, man.
Ain't nothing going to stick,
And I'm going to tell you why.
Okay.
Look at this Me Too movement.
Man.
No, hit how long? Not it, not I'm just saying when the what do we call it? When the system or when the system or when I guess the manhunt is on, they're not gonna stop. Okay. Eventually he's gonna go down.
Man, they are not gonna get him, dog.
I'm telling you.
Man, this man has flat out lied and flip flopped on all kinds of shit.
Talked about sexual assault.
The whole way through. Nothing. He got put in office after he did, got caught lying and all that shit.
It's coming.
It's not, man.
I'm sorry. I'm looking for the machine. When the machine is, they coming.
Man, he is above the machine.
This is just
machine,
another thing,
dog.
I'm telling you.
He's not going.
I think so.
The machine is on his side.
Now, I'm not saying it's going to be this year because they're, as far as impeaching, he's very arrogant. I can't see him quitting.
Man, we ought to make a bet about that.
So you think he's going to make it 4 years?
Yeah, easily.
Fact,
he
I
might
had,
make
I
eight.
I had that in my notes. You think he's going to make it through four?
He might make eight.
I don't think so.
All right. Okay, let's bet that.
That you saying that he's going to make four?
Yeah.
I don't think so.
No doubt.
He's only did one.
Let's put a double shot of 46 on it.
Okay, that'll work.
All right.
Double shot of 46. This is going to be when he exits the White House, right?
Yeah.
Or remodels that motherfucker again after 4 years. So y'all pay attention. We 4 years in. I guess 3 more years later.
Yeah.
When we doing the Shoot for the Hip show, we'll be talking about the bet we made with Trump. Because I don't think he's going to make it. But D. Montoya fully believes he will.
I want to go back to something. You said you was watching The Breakfast Club.
Yeah.
So I recently came across a little backlash that The Breakfast Club is getting.
But the black chick. Yeah. Or the black Latina.
Black Latina. Yeah. Afro-Latina chick.
Yeah, the dark-skinned Cardi B.
Oh, wow. Damn, boy. You are okay. Yeah. So have you seen the backlash they're getting?
I'm not understanding what's going on.
I don't get it either, except that
they said Charlamagne and Envy was acting like idiots.
Charlamagne asked the girl, what is she? Like, what's her race and nationality?
Yeah.
And she didn't seem fazed by it one bit. She just
looked like she blackface is what she doing.
She went ahead and asked, what's her people from the DR?
But she kind of her black skin sparkles a little bit extra.
Some of them Caribbean folks look like that.
Yeah.
That's natural. Yeah. I've seen that before. Okay. So it's like she didn't give a fuck.
Yeah.
Why is everybody else tripping?
Man.
I saw this response video. I almost stopped watching it after this moment. Like, why do you care?
Yeah.
He wasn't talking to you.
Mm-hmm.
Get the fuck out of here, man. Flip the channel. You don't want to see that shit.
Yeah.
Some people, I've been quit fucking with them. If you don't see what's wrong with this, well, bitch, watch something else. I don't give a fuck. Shit, I like the show.
All complaints be sent Shoot From Here one@gmail.com. CCDMontoyes.
I'm sorry calling a chick and all that. I don't remember her name. I just saw the backlash. I'm like, what? What's
she
wrong
don't love
with y'all?
Miami?
Yeah, sure. I don't know. All I know is she didn't care. She answered the question with a smile on her face. She had a perfect opportunity. It was two females there, and she wasn't outnumbered.
Yeah.
She could have said, hey.
But it wasn't given. They didn't say it disrespectfully.
They weren't disrespectful.
Okay.
See, man, goddamn, man. So I just like, damn, what you niggas mad about?
Man, I always got to get mad about
damn.
Something.
Damn. Anyway. Yeah, anyway, we can move on. From
okay,
that.
So Toys R Us is, matter of fact, I didn't tell my wife, my kids got gift cards at Toys R Us. They're closing 182 stores, and they plan to reinvent itself.
Oh,
they some kind of way. I don't know.
Man, they better. Somebody better buy them out. Amazon might want to buy them out.
That's what they did.
Amazon bought them?
Indirectly.
Oh, well, yeah.
They pushed them out is what they did.
Yeah, that's what happened.
So you got two things. One of the things you can do in business, you can buy somebody out and just kind of destroy them that way.
Yeah,
just
to that's make what Microsoft used to do.
Yeah. So,
that's kind of what Facebook does.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So, So they're closing their stores and they contribute this to Amazon, Walmart, Target. Those places you can do more than one thing.
Man, screw Walmart, man.
And a lot of times, Toys R Us is not in the best. It's not in the best spot for you to get to.
They didn't future-proof themselves, man.
You got to do it, man. Technology.
They did not future-proof themselves. That hurt, man. That was a brand name there for me, man.
Yeah, for real. I mean, I'm just going in there, man. It's kind of therapeutic sometimes.
Yeah.
You go to, you're like, man, nostalgia set in. Boy.
Yeah.
You know, you be like, man,
bikes all the way up to the roof.
Yeah, man. All kind of action figures. The whole. Whatever, Star Wars, the whole, you know.
Legos, Transformers,
yeah,
dog.
Yeah.
Then when the video game,
they
thing
tried
took off,
to make themselves. They tried to include Babies R Us into it.
Yeah,
and that worked. I guess that helped keep them afloat. But all of them aren't Babies R Us / Toys R Us.
Hey, speaking of that, Mo Lady set up a registry for the baby.
Okay, thanks, man.
Yeah,
all right. I already got an idea what I'm gonna do.
Oh shit!
They, Riedel's make baby shoes.
Okay. We'll start him out right.
Yeah. Anyway. Yeah. You got me hiding on the shelf. The government shut down for what? A day or
something? Yeah. I thought it was still shut down.
Nah, it's back.
Oh, okay.
But they're trying to stop from closing again.
Yeah.
I think one of the main issues is immigration and the wall.
The DACA, the Dreamers and all that.
Such shit like that. So, what are they going to send the Dreamers back?
Hold on.
Let me get this straight. The Dreamers are the kids of the...
The kids that were born here. The undocumented kids that were born here.
Man, you know what, though? Those kids, some of them get social security numbers. Well, I guess that means they're documented. But you know, some of the Hispanics, they sell those social security numbers.
Oh shit! I'm sorry, man. I got a hit from over Shiny over here.
Oh yeah,
yeah.
Boom!
Yeah, man. You get shit out of me on that. Damn boy, Mike, boy.
So yeah. So anyway, the thing with the wall I don't understand is, according to Trump, Mexico's supposed to be paying for it.
Yeah.
So I don't know what the big deal
Not though. There's no way.
Yeah. So.
That's your boy.
That's my band. Trump. Donald. The Donald, nigga.
The Teflon Donald.
Yeah.
Oh, man. I just did something right there.
I caught it.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah. So 559-825 cell phone to say 559-825 shot. The tech health front. This flu season is supposed to be the deadliest ever.
Tech health, man. We ain't getting no gunshot for that.
You right. Let me set these boys
out.
Yeah,
man. Come on with it, man. There you go.
Tech health front.
I like that there,
man. The flu season, like I said,
is serious.
It's the deadliest ever.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Glad I got my shot, man, because I went through it.
Too.
Yeah. I went through it. I had it coming out both sides,
They said kids are dying at an alarming rate. Dying? It's not even, 30 deaths already.
Wow, okay.
Yeah, and had me think I was looking at my son like, oh, shit.
Man, that's a bad timing for me, too.
Yeah.
Man.
Yeah, I don't understand, but there's some type of influence out there that just fucking people up.
Man, I tell you
so
what.
You haven't got your flu shot. I don't even know.
I say get it, man.
Yeah.
I used to be like kind of on the fence about that.
Flu shots.
Man, when it hit you, though, you be like, oh, shit.
Yeah.
You remember, I was almost like I fought through it.
Yeah.
Yeah, man, that ain't nothing to play with.
Oh, you call old mother-in-law, have her set you something up.
Yeah, right on.
Also, Amazon Go.
Yeah, they lit it off.
Yeah, you see it?
I saw it. I don't see how it went, though. I didn't see it.
Well, so you're supposed to download this Amazon Go app.
Okay.
You need the app to
and
go in the
store. And you need to have your location on and all that.
Oh, do you?
I would imagine.
Okay, yeah. So you're supposed to walk in there, and it's got sandwiches, salads, meal kits. You see these little meal kits?
Yeah.
You can find them all over the place. So that's what it's for. And they also said it's also to build a better relationship with people.
Really? By not having people in the store?
I think, well, yeah. But my thing, I think part of that is to just, it's just another way to keep the logo out there. And throughout your normal day, if you work in a business, you just walk in and out and you're thinking Amazon, Amazon, Amazon. Just like people think, first thing they pull out their phone, Facebook, Facebook, Facebook.
Yeah.
Pull out your phone, Amazon. Just all day Amazon. If you can keep your logo out in head front, that definitely works in the back of people's mind.
All right. Well, I heard a rumor that while you're talking about pulling out your phone and thinking Facebook. I heard that there's one phone out there that's looking to not can be continued.
And yeah, sure. Go ahead, bring that up, why don't you? So here's the deal: they're not gonna stop selling the phone. So what? I did read that, and I like that somebody posted that because they must didn't read the article too well.
Yeah.
So they're not gonna discontinue the phone and start selling other shit. Like a lot of times, because it's a very expensive phone to make.
Okay.
Say from a business perspective.
So we're talking about the iPhone X, y'all. Yes. Before we continue.
So
it's been a leak that they're going to stop building these iPhones.
So what happened is still selling. But what happened is once they start saying they're going to bring the new phone out, you know, a lot of times they might lower the price. But business mind, they said they'll just stop it and just bring out a new phone instead of like making a 5S or 5C.
Is that what
you're
saying?
Shit. Yeah.
So from what I was reading is that the 8 is selling better.
Again.
No,
they still winning. It's still more iPhones in the world than it is every Android phone.
That's negative. No, that's very incorrect.
So you telling me that there? I'm saying if you walk into a house like when my wife had a party, you walk into the house, you're gonna see more iPhones automatically.
No, it depends on where you go.
Hey, so you know people where we live at. It's not rural to me, but you know it's just not getting that much cell phone signal out here. And plus, some people I don't know, maybe don't have unlimited data. I don't know. Yeah. So people like. You know, what's your Wi-Fi password?
They're fiending for it. Like, no, you don't have a guest, like a different signal for guests.
No. So what I did, I said, come here, let me see your phone. So I whipped my phone out, and so I just put my phone next to theirs.
Uh-huh.
Bam, just like that. Oh, they lost their mind.
What happened? You sent them? They sent them the Wi-Fi?
Just like that. It locks them in.
Now, so that's cool.
Hey,
that is cool.
Hey. So by 7 people came up, right?
All
right. I was like, y'all line up. So I say, hey, BYT, check this shit out. He's sitting over there where that cooler was at. He's sitting down there on the cooler. I do this. They're like, oh. You know, like an Asian person walk around with a camera? They were like, oh. They were like, oh, shit. Man, BYT over there.
Your
like,
Asian impression, dog.
BYT
over there. Get you in some trouble.
BYT just sitting right. over there like, whatever, dog, with his drunk ass.
He was drunk?
Yeah.
Oh, I like to see a drunk BYT.
Hey, that's a good deal, man.
But yeah, that is cool, though. Yeah, I got to say.
So, yeah. So who sent that slander? Was that Corey?
No, I sent that.
Oh, you did? Who commented on it?
Corey commented on it.
I see you, Corey, over there hating.
No, that was Katie Davis. Black on both sides radio.
You know
over
what?
There.
He better not have an iPhone.
I don't know.
Somebody in his house got an iPhone.
He seemed like a more down to earth Android
Very
type of cat.
Yeah.
You know, you aloof ass iPhone ass people. Mm-hmm. You know, I don't know about y'all.
Man, that's them players out here, dog.
No, it's not. Them players got burners.
All right, we look like on time.
I know we passed 30. It's about time for that heat.
You got some heat lined
right
up?
Right at 30. Yes, I do.
All right, so we're going to go to a break, come back with the fuckery, and then we'll get this thing moving.
Yeah.
Whoa.
When I pull up, it's over. Oh, I pull up, it's over. When I pull up, it's over. Oh, I pull up.
Morning, riding, yawning, can't turn my beat up. On the way to a Bible with a grip that I can kick my feet up. See the candy was shining, freshly priming, first time I seen her. Now she wanna ride high with her head in the sky and look down on all her people. Ain't it crazy how pavement be cracking when I'm slapping them bows? Hoes go to jump in and can't find the hammers on my toes. So much twerking and working in here, I should install a pole. For them strippers that love to suck and fucking get down on the floor. Transformers can't fuck with this. Not the way my dome flip. Skyscraper tall when I creep. Crawl of that crit or solar clip. Rise of the apes in my trunk. When my terrier swang down. Make a pro catch goes like the rapture pro. When my old school come around.
When I pull up, it's over. Oh, I pull up.
Your girl said she wanna ride with a pimp, wanna get that dick that she deserves. Save her back seat softer than a pillow top. Paint so wet that it hit the spot and I'ma quench thirst. Mad little nigga shoulda did it first. You was holding hands and I was in a purse. I'm getting throwed up under city lights. She ride side shaking lipstick, tryna make sure that her titties right. We in the parking lot with the trunk open and sipping. Standing outside the wheel with the wood grain wheel like it's 1996. Yeah, trick, I'm riding dirty. Pick something, bitch, I know you heard me. Trying to get the leg with the 84s. Tag just gon' say beg for mercy. I just swerving, swinging, banging. Beware, cause a hoe might leave you hanging. Better let them know I'm forever holding. Kicking doors open, pay what you owe me. I told them,
I pull up, it's over. Oh, I pull up, it's over. Cuff your cheek, cuff your cheek, she hella legit, bitch.
pimping is what pimping is, and Mac can do what it feel like. Drip the drape with that tuck of stitch and them folds and folds, so I peel right. Candy paint on that body, man. Chromey grill and that woman. Them belts and bucks and fifth wheel on the truck, you and him be knocked when I'm coming. That face so hard that it's numbing. That chrome so shiny, it's blinding. Them seats so soft that I'm sinking in them, so it's no need to recline them. I drop the top and you see me. Got different shit on each TV. Got one with Sopranos and one with The Wire. The one up front is for a walk empire. Wood gray wheel so goddamn new, that sap come out when I grip it. I represent for that BAT and that H, the hoe I'm still tipping. I chunk the deuce when I'm flipping. For my city I put on R.I.P. to the pimp, this UGK for life, for real, and I'm gone. When I
pull up, it's over, over.
Man, hold up, dog. When I pull up, it's over. Hey, man, that was that Big Crip featuring Big Sun and Bun B. Pull Up, obviously, is the name of the song. And that came from the Live from the Underground.
Yeah, that's the newest.
That was old. That came out in 2012.
Okay, yeah. That was
probably shit
after
there.
Bun B and Big Crip had that talk.
Yeah?
Yeah.
They had a talk?
Yeah, you didn't know that?
What kind of talk?
Because there was a deal with, you know, he was sounding too much like Pimp C.
Really?
Yeah.
They really had to talk
they
about
really
that.
Talk. Nah, I mean, I don't know if it was like, nigga, you need to come holler at me. Wow. But it was kind of like they had a discussion. Bun B said, he like, yeah, man, I thought that at first too, but I had to talk cool. I mean.
Okay.
He didn't say, yeah, I had to come check. Man, he didn't say that.
He did come out sounding like Pimp C at first.
I mean, but that's what you.
He evolved, though.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, hey. See, matter of fact, he's a. Like overseeing Bun's new project, like he's
somebody need to see Bun's new project.
Yeah,
yeah, big time.
Yeah, well, that was the best I've heard Bun rap up for a while up until that point.
He out here struggling in these streets.
Yeah, man, but that
I mean, it happens, you know.
That's back when I had that Ford.
Yeah. All right, it's time for the fuckery part of the Shoot From the Hip show. And if you want to comment on anything we talked about, 559-825-7468, 559-825-SHOT. If you do not want to hear yourself on the radio or on these podcast streets, and you can clearly email us, shootfromthehip1@gmail.com. All right, did you hear that Bill Cobham made an appearance at a jazz club?
Yeah, I did.
What think about that?
I think look at old Bill peeking through the blinds here.
Yeah, they say he got his sight back.
All these motherfuckers. Yeah. yeah. He got his sight back when all the mother cats got caught up.
Yeah. But this Me Too movement, I think he can kind of slide up under.
Hey, window. Man, he's
trying to get a little fame.
He back out there in the streets.
He's 80.
Yeah. He's about to kick the bucket.
Yeah, so why not, you know, go out in a blaze of
glory? Oh, shit. Look, hey, man, he pulled up in his own.
Yeah.
Let them other cats kiss him.
Throwing roofies all over the place.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, a little Quaalude. You know?
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah.
Yeah, so, he made an appearance at a jazz club, you know, he told some, I guess he kind of did a little comedy, told some stuff, like, I guess some type of spoken word type storytelling type thing.
Yeah.
And he also played the
You drums. Know what a Quaalude is? I don't know what it is.
A Quaalude is something like a Molly back in the day.
Hey, Google, what is a Quaalude?
Here is some information about methaqualone.
Oh, shit. Okay. They got a whole.
Well, it said meth, so meth is involved.
Oh, well, yeah, it is. All right.
Yep. Hey, Siri. What is a Quaalude?
Methaqualone, sold under the brand name Quaalude and sometimes stylized Quaalude in the United States and Mantrax in the United Kingdom and South Africa, is a sedative and hypnotic medication. Do you want me to keep reading?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, whatever, she ain't gonna keep
All reading. That said to me was that Siri was a dope thing.
Yeah. So... I think it was Molly for the 70s and the 80s, and okay. I think a lot of people did it. I think, you know, just like when you drink, if you and a woman drinking, for the most part,
inhibitions go down a little bit.
Well, they do, but I think most of the time, men
bad decisions go up.
They do, but I think men can handle it more.
You think so?
They can handle, say we two, a man and woman drinking.
That's not the way I hear it.
I'm having trouble with the connection.
Okay. Her ass high. She was already late.
No, what I'm saying for the Quaalude thing back in the day, if and gonna reference of today's thing, if both people are drinking,
All right.
Don't you think you can handle your alcohol a little more than a woman?
I think everybody, when they're drinking, thinks they can handle their alcohol better than everybody else.
You know, most of the time when they was doing them Quaaludes back in the day. Because I don't know, you can't make it. Do you drop them in the drink?
I don't know how it works.
If you take them or swallow them or whatever,
don't,
I would.
Don't try to incriminate me, then. Right. I ain't touched it.
Yeah. So if you, I just think women can't handle whatever shit.
Ooh, a lot of misogyny in the drug alcohol game.
Well, they can't. So a lot of times they are, you know, having sex. And then
man,
they,
I've always heard that women handle it better.
Alcohol?
Yeah, no, I've always heard that. I don't know.
No, no, not at all.
Okay, brother.
I don't know. Shit, well, I guess you drink on some Stone Cold.
No, I'm not saying what I witnessed. I've just heard that. Because I can't say. First off, this is not a bragging point, but I handle mine better than most people.
Well, yeah, we know.
You know, so everybody kind of be looking fucked up to me after a while, mm-hmm. while I'm chilling.
Yeah.
And that, I'm trying to back up off of that, man. I'm slowing up, man.
Well, yeah, I hear you.
Y'all should have seen the face, man.
Hey.
He does not believe me.
So, Black America's golden child, Tiffany Haddish, she had some problems pronouncing words, and they were doing the Oscar, they were naming the Oscar nominees.
Yeah.
And she fucked up a lot of names.
Cool.
Twitter went crazy.
Good.
I think she had a little fun with it.
Yeah, you know, fucked them up always, on purpose.
I don't think she fucked them up on purpose. But I think because she's a natural goofball,
yeah,
they took it as that. They
I
had
like
a little fun with it. So
she get up there and show her ass a little bit.
Yeah.
And that old white bread ass award ceremony. Yeah. I dig it.
Yeah.
Put it in their face.
She added a little, what do you call that, to it? She added
some soul there.
Nah, I wouldn't call it soul.
Some ratchetness.
Yeah, that.
Oh well,
you know, because she's ratchet.
She got.
I think people
that.
Mistake her ratchetness for comedy.
No, that's her.
Well, I just think
that's her.
It's more ratchetness than it is comedy. She's not that funny to me.
Yeah, well, I've laughed.
Really?
Yeah,
I haven't.
But a lot of it is kind of
over
hood,
the top.
It's like, hood radish.
Yeah.
What's her name? Tiffany Hood Radish.
Yeah. Hey, you see that guy?
Ooh, what guy?
You missed him. He's on a Netflix show. He's on that show, The Chi, and he played Eazy-E in South.
Yeah, Park. Yeah, I've man, seen it.
He getting a lot of acting gigs.
Yeah, man, I saw the interviews with him. I watched me and old lady watched the third episode of The Chi.
Are you up on? You seen them all?
Yeah,
it's pretty good.
Yeah,
I like it. I mean, much as I was
talking bad about,
well, I would it, no, that the concept. Was, yeah, yeah. It just the wire, the hood, the concept of.
Yeah, but it's well done though.
It is. That's what I was getting. It's a good show.
Yeah,
it shows a few sides, you know, of and it ain't too. There's good stories involved.
It's a good mixture, man. Yeah. It ain't all just beating you across the head with
dope dealing and all that.
Yeah, that there. So, but you been paying attention to the awards season? You know, the Oscars, the Grammys, and all that?
I don't never pay attention to that shit. Unless the headline come across like my news feeds on my phone. I got several different news feeds.
All right.
That's the only time I know or something like that. Do I care? Like, am I that involved in who in caring?
Yeah.
No.
Okay.
Unless Black Twitter tells me that there's a Black actor or actress involved in, you know, that might be up for an award that they're probably not going to win.
I'm still not, I shouldn't say amazed, but I still don't get why they care so much about the Black folks. Why they care so much about these awards and who gets snubbed and all
the acceptance.
Yeah.
We still fighting for that.
I know. And that's, you know, I don't want to go back.
It's easy
to the dead horse.
It's easy to say when you get on shit, but just not how it works.
Yeah, it can though. But all you got to do is do it.
Yeah.
I mean, they tried it and it was kind of.
The reason that's not going to work when you're talking about just Oscars, that means movies, is. Like, that would be fine if we had our own movie studios.
Like Tyler Perry.
Well, yeah, but his shit is stupid.
But still, though, but they have access to stuff like that, man.
You have that, and then we went and supported all our Black movies. But that just don't work like that. That's just not how it works.
Yeah, but it can, though. That's all I'm saying.
It can until they start having rappers there, and then they start fighting behind the scenes and shit. And then
I think that goes on all across the board, man.
I don't think so. You think people fight at the Grammys?
Yeah,
I don't think so.
I think they get
fist fights.
They get drunk at the parties and shit
they
don't
get
come out
drunk.
They keep their lips shut. Better. Nah,
I'm talking about gang banging and violence.
Yeah, well, violence is violence. I don't care what kind of adjective or qualifier you put on it.
Yeah,
and shit goes on. We just don't see it.
Okay. Well,
yeah.
All right. Everyday Struggle has returned.
Yeah, you with a new cat.
With a new cat.
And a new old cat.
So, of course, you've seen Odeska and Academics and Star, starring Buck Wildfang was on there.
Yeah, I don't even remember that.
You don't remember who?
I mean, starring Buck Wild.
You don't remember?
I remember the name.
Okay.
I don't remember watching that.
Well, it's not like now where you can see the Breakfast Club on YouTube and shit like
yeah,
that.
I didn't keep up with it.
Back then, New York radio was New York radio.
Yeah.
Now, New York radio is kind of like a worldwide thing.
What LA radio.
We were in high school.
Oh, we were in high school.
Well, I mean, but you know, it's always radio and then there's New York radio.
Yeah, I get you.
And he was the top guy. Yeah. You know, he's the top guy in the mecca of New York radio.
Yeah. I heard he's more gutter than Button.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Because he don't give a fuck. And they'll tell you he don't give a fuck. And he be shitting on people. He made a name for shitting on people.
Yeah.
No, Button just an asshole. Okay. I mean, well, he's a dickhead. Well, Star, he is that, but that's his personality. I think Joe Button, he doesn't purposely be an asshole. He's just a fucking sorry ass person.
Oh.
Well, I think Star has.
Damn.
Star swung us into like some type of, you know, he swung us into like, you know, his niche, you know, so to speak. But Button. It's not Button's niche. He just a clown, so to speak. I don't know if that.
Well, you got a lot of negative adjectives for Button over there.
Because he whack, man.
Damn, boy.
Because he talks all this shit, and it just so like whatever, dude. Like he make reasons to disagree.
Well, yeah, sometimes.
You know, I'm just gonna disagree just to disagree.
Well, you need those people out there, man.
He is a cornball.
Okay. Yes, sir. As he sips his wine, he back on his wine, y'all.
That's right, dog.
Hey, and if shit jumps off the rails, that's why.
Nah.
Just so you know.
Don't put that on me. So when the show opened up, you heard Michael Blackson talk about Monique.
Yeah.
Monique has a big gripe with Netflix.
Yeah.
So she said that she wanted people to boycott Netflix. She was offered $500,000 for her Netflix special.
Right.
And I guess she went on. She wanted to know why.
That's
a
lot of damn money, man.
For normal people, but not for a veteran comedian.
Yeah.
I mean,
does she have any other deals on the table to be shitting on that one?
That's the problem.
Come on, man.
So when Netflix, what they talked to her about was, it's pretty much you don't have the pull. They pretty much said you don't have the pull to be demanding the kind of money.
And that would
you
be
want.
Correct.
Well, I will say this, that I definitely think Monique is worth more. I think at a stand-up, Monique kills it. You kidding me? I've seen her stand-up.
I've laughed at her some
of funny, and she's smart, too. But I think Monique is great.
Her niche is just fat jokes, though, really.
No, yeah, man. Dog. Monique is good. She's better than Tiffany Haddish.
Yeah, I'll give you that.
I think she's smart. I think she's clever. First of all, of course she don't have the look.
Clever.
Oh, she is awesome as a comedian, man. Clever, she is awesome as
she
a comedian.
She tells those low-hanging fruit jokes, in my opinion, man.
Well, I mean, there's a skill to that. Right there? She's a skill to that, and I think she's mastered that. I think she's great. I think she's a great comedian. I'm going to give her props, personally. That's how I feel.
I see you doing that.
But I will say that I agree a little bit with Netflix on the demand for her. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I think she'll always be there. And I think what Netflix does is they ride who's hot and in business, you try to see how you can make this person make money. And I feel that, you know, Schumer was hot. She mentioned Schumer in her rant.
Yep.
Schumer's hot. You know what I'm saying? It's, you know, Chappelle has a market value for his name. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
He has history. Chris Rock, to me, is just a legend. He is Chris Rock. As great as I think Monique is, I just think, you know, she doesn't have that. I think Samore is a great comedian. Unfortunately.
Samore?
Yeah.
She was just raunchy, too.
Well, she is raunchy, but she's a great comedian. I think Cheryl Underwood is great. I've seen her in person. She is awesome. She's a great comedian. For whatever reason, well, I know the reason, America is just not going to run to go see. See, like, we might support Monique, but I don't know if a white person scrolling through their Netflix is going to go see Monique.
And that's true.
That's the problem. So, like, Amy Schumer is Amy Schumer. And then you might get a lot of black people who heard about Amy Schumer. So, they're gonna watch it, too.
But you don't think the flip side of
it? I don't think Monique is going to get that. Well, but now, so I believe that Monique is awesome. I think
everything, think she was lowball? Bottom line.
She was lowball, but I know why she was lowball. Now, do I think she should have got 500,000? No. I think she should have got a few million, you know. So at least half.
Do you agree
Amy
with
Schumer
her tactics in protesting it?
I agree based upon how I feel about her talent.
Okay.
Now, business wise, I understand Netflix. I'm not gonna I don't know that I'm not, because I understand where Netflix is coming from. Yeah. I'm not gonna not watch Netflix.
So you know how you always preach, don't fuck up the paycheck.
Right.
Do you think she just fucked up her paycheck?
On this?
Yeah. No, it going forward. Because I do.
With Netflix.
I think, which first though, she's been blackballed in the industry for some years
right,
now.
Right.
Because she kind of got exactly. a shitty attitude.
Right.
So she already been fucking up the paycheck.
Right.
Then she gets a paycheck offered to her and fucks that up too.
Yeah.
I have no sympathy for her big ass.
Nah. Well.
I don't. See, even though I can recognize her talent and maybe she deserves more
I
than
think
that.
She's very talented.
But come on, dog. Talent or no talent. Get your money.
No, really.
Get your money.
I agree with that.
So shut your mouth. You know, if you don't want no money, then shut up.
Well,
then.
I think there's that. I think she could have declined it and not said
that. Don't ask us to jump on your right. bandwagon with your rich ass.
Yeah, right.
Get out of here, man.
Why, you think she that rich?
She got, man.
More money than me and you.
If she got enough money to turn down $500,000.
Well, yeah, that too.
Well, goddamn.
Yeah. So
I can't imagine.
Yeah. I
get $500,000. I might not work anymore.
Oh, I don't know about that.
Shit.
I can go through $500,000 quick.
Well, I mean, I could, but I think I'd make it work.
Well, yeah. I believe that she could have taken it, and her people could have tried to come up with a business plan to make it work. Maybe she could have did the Netflix special, and she could have swung that into make it more. I think she needs to also understand the plight of the black entertainer. You know what I mean?
The plight of the black entertainer.
Because they're going to be lowballed. You're going to get less. This is like Eminem. Eminem going to sell out stadiums where, you know, somebody who's greater than him might sell out a small arena.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying?
All right.
So, she needs to kind of not fuck up her paycheck. You know what I'm saying? She could have been a little more strategic about it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Because, like, when she's doing all of this complaining, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Once nobody cares anymore, they're not gonna care anymore. You're just gonna be stuck.
And she just signed her check, her death ticket, man.
I think somebody's gonna come up. I don't think she's done.
I don't see it happening.
She's been talking about Oprah Perry, Tyler Perry, and Oprah Winfrey Perry. And stuff like that. But now I did agree with one thing she said. She said that you never seen Oprah at a Stellar Award, all of them Black Awards, and those. Yeah. You never seen her there.
Mm-hmm.
But that don't mean Oprah ain't doing great stuff.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I mean, she can't be everywhere.
Right.
Is it in her best interest to go to the Gospel Awards talking about, you know?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Or can she just make her money and on the low, not on the low, but just get the money you can and do what you want with it to help, you know, whatever cause.
Yeah.
See, that's a lot.
I'm out on Monique, dog. I'm out.
What's that? See?
Done.
Yeah.
I hate when you coming from a position of privilege, but you begging people who are under you
mm-hmm.
to follow your lead on some shit like that.
Yeah.
Y'all don't, they did me wrong, so y'all don't fuck with them no more.
Yeah.
I'm done.
Do you think, well, she also said, you know, she might, she, okay. Do you think she's taking a hit for the next Tiffany Haddish?
I doubt it.
You don't think so?
Mm-mm.
So you just think Netflix will say, if you hot, I'm going to give you what
yeah,
I think you want.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Netflix has a track record of not really caring about your gender or color.
That's true.
So, you know, after seeing all of that, even the name she dropped out there, it was all black and female.
Yeah.
It's like, you didn't do yourself no favors.
Yeah.
And you ain't hot.
She can come off a little abrasive when she's doing that complaining. Hey,
she done. I don't want to hear shit else from her.
I'm a fan. I like Monique.
Man,
I like Monique.
She out of there to me.
And I think Monique is a great comedian. I think she's funny.
Yeah.
And I hate to see. I can understand her frustrations, but at the same time, I do. Just going back to what I've been preaching since we started this podcast, I do believe you need to get your money because at the end of the day.
Get your money.
At the end of the day, when everybody's talking all that shit, you know, I don't believe that nobody's going to care about you in a year or two. You understand what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Like, you know, that's just how the world works. People always want to get on the train and they down with you when you bitch complaining because they can get on their cell phone and say, yes, bitch.
There you go. I thought you was going to go and show what I'm doing it, boy. He didn't pull it out.
So But like I say, man, at the end of the day, nobody's going to help you pay your bills. You know, you could be rich. You could be famous. Your house could be, like, if you were, let's just say you're an entertainer. You got a house in California, but you maintain a house here in Houston. And shit go left, just like your boy, what's your man name though? He's from Houston, went to Willow Ridge. He was on the Grey's Anatomy.
Yeah, Washington. Washington.
When it's over, man, it's Isaiah over, Washington. Man. So I just think sometimes you need to get your money while you can.
Yeah, man, see it. So she better, unless she comes out with her own shit.
Yeah, you know, if you're religious, man, do a lot of praying about it, man. Nobody cares. Nobody's going to, man, you can speak up for shit all you want, man. At the end of the day, nobody going to care about you when the next hot person come along.
Right.
You know, so, you know, it is what it is. If you feel any kind of way about it, you already know. I keep reading this phone number. Y'all need to use it, 559-825-7468, 559-825-SHOT. The same, this is real close to Kaepernick. I think Kaepernick could have shut his mouth, and he could have, on the low, I'm just saying, not on the low, but his movement, you know, a lot of famous people, you know, entertainers, famous people, they have charities, and his cause could have been for, you know, social justice and all that, you know, him having people fuck stand or sit for the national anthem and getting Trump involved in it and all of that shit. Man, my laptop is shot.
Hey, all right, dog. I think we beat that dead horse, man.
Yeah, I'm trying to open my laptop. Anyway, so like I said, let's move on to the next topic of the day. And have you ever heard Tekashi 6ix9ine?
No.
He's a Mexican and Puerto Rican rapper from Brooklyn, New York.
Oh, you said Mexican like it was dirty.
Oh, I didn't say he's a Mexican.
Okay. It came across like you're a Mexican.
I didn't mean it. Like, that's not where I'm going with this.
I know. I'm just jumping in and fucking with
what
you, man.
What the fuck is wrong with this motherfucker? Okay. So anyway, him and Casanova, or Cass Two Times, Casanova, whatever. Okay. Another dude from Brooklyn.
Yeah.
They beefing.
I'm familiar. They beefing now.
Yeah, they beefing.
For what?
I forgot.
Is it over a chick?
No, it's not over a chick. I can't remember what the deal is, but I know they both from New York.
Some disrespect, son?
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah, well, there you go.
But you know, a lot of times, it's not about you and that person. It's about your clique versus that clique.
Yes.
So
most of the time, it is.
If you go and watch, my laptop.
Hey, Inside Baseball, the Reese's Mac is giving him the blues.
It is giving
right
me the blues. Right. It's all right. We're going to get this taken care.
He can't even get right over here with his thoughts right now.
Hey, listen.
Meanwhile, this Dell XPS 13 is purring like a kid.
Okay, you go sell that. You put them motherfuckers on one side. Shit. So, I think I know why it's messed up. But anyway, Tekashi 6ix9ine and
looking
Casanova.
Look at that porn, Nick. Stop that.
Nah, that ain't it.
Okay.
I'm looking at porn for years. They ain't fucked up none of my other computers.
All right.
They beefing. They've been going back and forth. But Tekashi 6ix9ine, he's a little guy. The thing that I hate about rap beefs is...
He's a short dude?
Yeah.
What's the 6ix9ine for then?
I don't know. There's a lot of...
Like he's like one step above Royce the 5'9"?
Yeah,
is that what he doing?
Yeah, I guess so. I don't think that's what he's doing. Not lyrically, anyway. He just one of them... Yeah, he remind me of... You know, he sounds like... he sounds like them guys, M.O.P.?
Yeah.
Kind of yells, screams a lot. Yeah. And he just says a lot
hit
of...
Hit him.
Yeah, he says a lot of like shit.
And
that,
yep.
A lot of violent shit, a lot of disrespectful shit, and it just sound good when you rap about it.
Yeah.
So that's what he does.
Like Zero.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So anyway, he has a video.
I just got you to say that he sounded good.
No, that's not...
Jedi mind tricked you.
Hey,
got it.
Tekashi 6ix9ine. Is not a tough guy.
Okay.
He looked like a what's the dude that's from Houston that lifts a lot of weights now? White dude. Got all them colors and shit. He been on MTV.
Talking about Riff Raff?
Yeah. He looked like a
Riff Raff in the gym?
He looked like a Riff Raff that don't go to the gym. You ever seen Tekashi 6ix9ine?
No.
Ask Google.
I'm gonna fuck his name up.
Okay, Google, show me a picture of Tekashi 6ix9ine.
Motherfucker heard you. Hey Google. Show me a picture of Tekashi 6ix9ine.
Check out these pictures.
Oh, okay, there you go. I see him. Look like you seen that
Riff Raff that don't lift weights.
You ever saw that Skittles commercial where the dude had it on his face?
Yeah,
that's what he looked like.
So anyway, he say a lot of dumb shit about rapping and shooting and pulling guns and all of that bullshit. Yeah. So for whatever reason, him and Casanova, they both from Brooklyn, But Tekashi 6ix9ine.
That's racial, dog.
You can't not be racial.
Yeah, it is.
You can't not be famous.
Yeah, it is. That's what they beef is.
Well, Tekashi 6ix9ine is blood affiliated, which I think is fucking idiotic. He did a video, and I'm thinking he in Brooklyn. Everybody in there got red. Everybody just red, red, red.
That shit is worldwide now, man.
It is worldwide.
That gang banging in Germany, man.
Yeah, but I tell you what. This dude, Tekashi 6ix9ine, he will not live to be 30.
Yeah.
Oh, he's not going to be out in
Well, we see, man. Y'all know you got low expectation of these rappers as it is.
Big time.
So, I think he could switch it up.
What? He done.
He could switch it up.
He ain't. He done. First of all,
they young, man.
His music is not good.
He going to parlay that shit into something else.
Hey.
Did you see how Pitbull switched up? You remember when Pitbull first came out?
Pitbull ain't tattered. Pitbull got sweatsuits and shit now.
Nah, yeah, but when he first came out,
I know it.
He was thugging and bugging.
Yeah.
And then he switched up to wearing them suits. Somebody in his family got a hold of him, like, hey, clean up your shit. He cleaned it up, and now he's cleaning up in the bank.
I met Pitbull. Is that right? Before. Yeah, downtown. Okay.
Who else switched it up? Pink. Remember when Pink first came out?
No, they tried to make Pink black.
Well, it worked for a minute. She was getting played on the Urban Station.
Yeah, but and that wasn't
she,
her.
She swapped it up.
Yeah.
Anybody seen, what's the Australian chick name?
Iggy
Azalea. Anybody seen that lately?
Man, about track.
Like, exactly. They can switch it up, man.
So do your research, and I would really like to know where their beef is, because Casanova claims to be about their life.
Yeah,
I like to see him go one-on-one.
Ain't that one of them on my radar.
I think it's going to end ugly.
Yeah, nah, it ain't.
I think so, man. These are because of who.
I think you want to see it in ugly.
No, I really don't.
So you can be right.
No, because of who they have behind them. You got a bunch of, no, and I'm going to tell you why. Do you remember Bobby Shmurda?
Yeah.
That shit ended ugly for him. He was affiliated. He did a lot of tough guy talk, and those guys pumped him up. He was going by the vibe of the people around him.
Yeah, well.
And I think Tekashi 6ix9ine is doing that. He's being very disrespectful. Yeah. But he got the bloods behind him.
Hey, man, get them Shutter Island dudes gone.
Get them niggas
get them gone.
Out of here. Oh, trust me. They going to both be done.
Kill yourself.
They both going to be done.
There you go.
So,
on to the next thing.
Okay. If I can get my laptop to work here.
Well, I tell you what. I got the sports sitting right here.
Hold on. I got one more thing.
All right.
Then we're going to get to some sports on the Shoot From The Hip show.
My homeboy was talking about getting a sex doll, so y'all know I had the roaster. What kind of man is going to have sex with an inanimate object? Bruh, it shouldn't be that difficult to get a woman, man. I was killing him. And then I saw her. Nigga. Maybe I'm tripping. Maybe I need to stop being so judgmental. I live in Los Angeles, so... You know, some fake breast or fake butt, that's close to realism to me. Besides, this one won't go through your phone. I don't have to remember her birthday, get her nothing for Valentine's Day, for Christmas. Ain't never got to meet her parents. Ain't never got to worry about what she been doing all day. She been in the closet where I left her all day. I probably wouldn't even put her in the closet because I'm not even ashamed. As a matter of fact, when you come over my house, you got to speak to her. Hey, what's up, y'all? Hey, appreciate you coming over. Say what's up to Jasmine. I'm going to do it.
Anyway, that was who the hell is Ryan Davis. I'm sure y'all know who he is. Y'all want to see the rest of that video.
Them dolls been floating around the doggone internet.
Man, that shit is crazy. And I'll post a few videos about this crazy shit on the Facebook page.
I've seen a couple, man, posting cats going in, man. They really? Have some fun with this one.
Yeah, they are. But the sad part about it is the fact that... Motherfuckers really buying this shit.
I don't believe they are. This is just on the internet, man.
Really?
Yeah, ain't nobody buying that.
Really?
Them things like $200,000 or something like that, ain't
not $200,000.
Just $2,000.
I don't know.
Yeah, whatever it is, it ain't cheap.
It is molded plastic, ain't it?
Whatever it is, it ain't cheap. And most cats that probably need something like that ain't buying that. They don't have the money for that.
I think he's dope. Cause you know what?
It's all comedy.
It is comedy, but even when Beats headphones came, I know Beats, they still expensive.
Yeah.
But you can find knockoffs online. You can find somebody in the hood selling that shit.
The corner store where they sell
the tall tee. Yeah.
They would have knockoff dolls.
It'll be like at the Mexican Sharp Town or whatever.
Oh, man.
They have the little Indian dudes.
At the little flea market.
You know, it's people out here that study the spending habits of niggas.
That's hilarious.
And somebody will find this shit.
First off, if anybody's buying it, it ain't black folk. I'm sorry, they not buying it.
I think these niggas will buy it. Them motherfucking niggas from the penitentiary.
I don't believe
them Shutter Island niggas.
I don't believe it.
Man, come on, man. You got tattoos all over your face. You can't meet no chick. You get you one of them.
You can meet your little hood rat.
Well, fat chick, too.
Whatever. All I'm saying is they ain't buying them dolls, man. But it is funny.
Hey, man. I'm telling you, man.
I've seen some chicks. Well, if you just like something fake, then so be it. They got a little hurt in their feelings, man, about it.
So what are you? You actually fuck this doll?
Yeah, I guess. I don't know.
Man.
I haven't seen all the autonomy on it. Or the anatomy. I fucked that up. The anatomy on it.
All right. All right, let's get to some sports talk on Shoot From The Hip. Show, you got your shit ready?
Yeah, I got it.
Hold on.
Oh, yeah.
There you go.
Get the girl over here.
You fucking up, dog.
No, you fucking up. All right, so we were remiss last week to do the picks, so we're not even going to worry about last week. But I will do is cap.
Really?
Yeah, we didn't pick last week.
Oh, we didn't pick at all?
No.
I thought we just forgot to. Okay.
No, we didn't even pick. So we can't use that one. We gotta skip it.
Whoop.
But so I'm not even gonna go over the games. I'm just gonna go over where we stand. Well, yeah, I'll go over the game. It'll help out. All right. The week before last, it was KC versus the Titans. We both went KC and we was both wrong.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh, that's you right.
And then the other game was the Falcons versus the Rams. You went the Rams. Hold up, man.
You went Dirty Bird?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then we did the Bills versus Jags. You went the Jags. You was right again.
What you pick?
I picked the Bills.
Ding!
All right. And what else here? Okay, and then there was the Panthers versus the Saints.
You know what I did?
Yeah, you went the Saints.
What you go?
I went the Panthers, dog.
Ding!
So, in the divisional round, it was the Falcons versus the Eagles.
Mm-hmm.
I went the Eagles.
Okay.
Ding! Then we went Titans versus Patriots, and we both went the right way on that. That was a no-brainer.
Okay.
The next one was the Jags versus the Steelers.
Mm.
I went the Jags.
Ding!
Then we went Vikings versus Saints. We both went the Saints.
Mm.
Damn.
I know, right?
So guess what, dog?
What?
We sitting at 4-0.
Really?
4-4. And now we got the damn
Super
Bowl.
So all we need
Bowl.
Is a Super Bowl then.
All we need is a Super Bowl. This bitch came down to the last one.
Okay.
Oh, shit.
I'm going Patriots. Fuck that.
That ain't right.
It ain't?
No. Well, shit, man. Because, hell, how you going to go against the Patriots? That's cold. Okay.
Okay, Google.
No, I'm going to go Patriots with you because I just don't believe the Eagles going to do it.
Okay, I go Eagles.
No, we just picked the tiebreaker.
I'm going Eagles.
Oh, you just going to go Eagles?
I'm going Eagles, though. I think they got something for the
Patriots. You really not going to go Patriots on this?
No,
you
I'm
just,
not.
What you're doing here is just giving me a shot of whiskey.
No, I'm not.
Okay, all right.
Did you think I didn't think the Jaguars going to be the Steelers.
Yeah,
the Patriots have not won every Super Bowl they've been in.
That's true.
So
they're not winning this one.
You don't know that.
All right, man. Look, I don't want them to win. Don't get me wrong. I see the writing on the wall here,
hey,
man.
Listen, dog. Let me tell you
the
something.
Writing is on the wall, Jack.
Yeah.
Anyway, so you going Eagles, I'm going Patriots.
I'm going Eagles.
All
they
right.
They got a good running game. They got that mixture. They got the boy from Miami. That the Eagles traded for.
Mm-hmm.
Got solid defense.
Mm-hmm. Sell it, dog.
They got Aguilar.
Yeah, sell it.
They got a bad white one. You know, they got Alshon Jeffrey. That boy catch radius is huge.
Sell it, dog.
You got them claws, dog.
Yes, indeed.
They don't have, man, Nick Foles, 6'6", like 6'7", man. He can see old.
I don't give a damn about no height.
Okay.
They don't mean shit to me.
They had a winning record with him at the start.
Hey, man, well, you did it.
Yeah,
I want my double shot. All right, get here between this one and Trump making 4 years, dog. I'm gonna be a drunk.
Only
man.
Double shot you gonna get is at my house.
Okay,
the Eagles gonna win this one.
They are not. Yeah, I'm gonna let you have it.
All right, though, that's gonna do it for this week of the Shoot
From
The Show with
here,
D. My Choice of Reach 559-825-7468 from the _hip on Twitter. Shoot From The Hip 1@gmail.com is the email. Hopefully, next time we record, my laptop will be working.
Yeah.
So anyway, I got nothing left. Got anything else?
No, that's gonna do it, man.
Poof.
Deuce out the roof. Poof. Deuce out the roof. Poof. Deuce out the roof.
fresh out the blue. Eighth time, come on. Northside, come on, come on. East side, come on, come on. Southside, come on, come on. Southwest side, come on, come on. Mo City, come on. What? Eighth time, come on. What? Bay time, come on. What? What? VA, come on. What? Fifth Ward. What? Bone Hard. Lost Ness. No stress. I'm talking about.